their work and how they operate in Nigeria should be limited. Very, very well. I'm not saying anybody should leave just position like that, because if they leave, it can even cause another problem in Nigeria, because many of them have know how to carry gun and manage them. So if they manage to frustrate all of them now, it can cause another thing. But my opinion is that they should look for a way of amending their works and how they do things, so that it could not be a kind of things that will cause, because they have wasted many lives. And they don't have reason of doing them, though, but because they were given much authority to function, let the authority and the operation be limited.
My opinion is, you see, every security agent in Nigeria need restructuring, not only SACS.
Well, SACS was set up by the Nigeria, by federal government. But my opinion is not as if that you end them like that. But the part is the aspect of unnecessary killing and a legal job. That's the aspect that I'm against of.
Yeah, my own opinion about it is, I don't think they should end SARS, but I think they should actually clarify SARS on their actual duties. That is, they shouldn't be disturbing youths or disturbing anyone at all. They should actually focus on armed robbery, kidnapping, anti-cultism. Those are actually the things I feel SARS is meant for, not harassing anyone, or just see someone on the road and you just stop them and harass them. You want to look at their privacy and all that. It's not supposed to be done that way. They're actually supposed to clarify them and make sure that they follow their rules, you understand? So that's what I feel about the SARS issue.
You see, the SARS, the government should just go ahead and ban them. The SARS is too much. They have caused cry in so many homes. They have destroyed so many homes. Because when you kill somebody, somebody just tries in from a family and just kill him without any cogent reason. Why? They were created to protect us. If they are no more protecting us, they are not killing us, then we should go ahead and ban them. It is from the taxpayers' money they are using to pay their salary. I believe those people who are saying they should retain them are using them for their own personal ends. So government should just go ahead and ban them.
Bros, they need to end SARS. I know, lie you. See, you see this man with the mantle. Now SARS give me for Benin Road, those Benin SARS before you enter Benin. And then give me this one so. Just for what? They don't understand my language. I send message to my brother. Say, see, bawo ni aye, which is how your life. The guy don't understand. He say I be courtist. Say because of the aye way they are be aye. The next thing I just say, you know if you ask me a question, I slap. Carry stick, one wipe my user and block her. Oh God, what can I do? He say glass way day, I know be ordinary. What can I do? I can't be courtist. How? I even they fear whether I don't send something enter my phone. Bros, what can I can't see and send a message you have sent to my brother. How your life? But will I hear? And I turn me into courtist. So, you know, even question me, I beat him be the next thing. After I can't chat, oh, guy, he beats me for nothing. He say, and the guy in a game, when I leave me, they go. See, and the max, anytime I see him, I they swear for them. Always, now so you be.
They should end it.
Why?
Because what they're doing is not fair. Like in my streets. I'm from Imo State. In my streets, the way they do the boys there, I don't like it. They come in the night, in the morning, in the afternoon to molest those boys and collect money from them for no reason. So they should end this.
I just believe it should end because the harassment is too much for every young man out there in the streets. When you just see them, they just want to harass and stop the person. If they see the person dressed as you, even as I am dressed because of my work, they will still want to stop you. And you know, want to look at your phone, and I don't even understand why they want to do things like that. So it should just end. I believe it should stop.
For the SARS, Abi, you know, for me, SARS, for Nigeria to end them, I'm very happy for that. Because, let's say, killing innocent is too much all over. Not only Lagos here, many states, even my state, used to happen. You understand? So for me, it's the best.
Now let me put it, I will say two things. Number one thing is this. Now it's not any side that matters. What is happening now, the fault is from the federal government. Now, such people, their police department, right? If they are doing what is not right, it is the function of the federal government or commissioner of police or whatsoever to call them to order. This is not the first time police brutality is happening in this country. Before this thing has been happening, people have been complaining and government has not been responding well. Now, it's not any size that matters. The police, this thing has to be restructured. not end. Everywhere there is police brutality. But to some extent, some government in the civil last war, they are trying to curb the excesses. It's not ending that matter. It's to restructure the police.
You know, SARS has brutally hurt the young boys, and it's not the law of humanity. It's not good, it's not the best. You know, we all have the right to live and not to kill. People where they are meant to protect us and then say they kill us. How you take B? You know good now, my brother. Reason them now. I want to say as this life they see that they enjoy. Person just come kill you for no reason. You know make sense. You know make sense. Moreover, this ourselves, they will catch person. They will do self-search. Nobody is a criminal in Nigeria. We are all youth. Hustling for a living. So for you to catch us and say self-search, it's not appropriate. Trust me, brother, you can testify to it.
Well, I believe SARS should be retrained, should be retained, but their operations should be structured. They should not be moving from street to street harassing people, but they should be like a normal police unit where they have their offices around. And if there's any issue or any security breach that need their attention, they should be called, or through their own personal security network, they can go to church scene or crime scene and arrest the situation. But it's wrong for them to be going from street to street. Some of them even dread like criminals. They won't even know, mostly along Benin or Road. If you are traveling, they stop vehicles. They look at the young guys if they feel they are okay. Or anybody holding a big phone, they stop you and start searching your phone. And even if you have anything incriminating in your phone, the way they will even harass the person, instead of talking to you, why do you have this? You kind of profile the person, ask what your she is doing. You know, you do your investigation. Not as if you started harassing them, and even people complain to you that what was happening here, started cocking your gun. I've seen it before happening. So for me, SARS should be retained, but their operation should be highly professional. And they should look at those who will be in SARS unit. It should be those who have experience and who are educated, not some riffraffs. Because currently now, those in staff, most staff are operatives. If you have a dialogue with one of them, you understand that they have those upstairs. The only thing they use is that gun. And they believe that by that gun, they can do whatever they want to have their way. So for me, they should be retained, but they should be structured.
The special anti-robbery squad, you know, they've actually done more harm than good in this country. Do you get? They've killed a lot of people. The organization that is supposed to be protecting us, now we are afraid of them. You know, they are meant to be a kind of shield for us in the country. But as a result of the fact that the body does not really have, you know, laws regulating their activities, they just come out to do whatever they like. So SARS is a threat to our lives. So I think it is high time the government eradicated, you know, the special anti-robbery squad. So that's my opinion about it. They are not helping us. They are not protecting us. They are just here to wreak havoc. So I guess it is time the government do something about it.